We do want to point out to you, however, that that place that you want to be, once you get there, will only provide a platform which will cause you to launch more rockets. In other words, you never really get to the final place, because each new vantage point also brings new contrasting experiences which the creator in you synthesizes into the yet new idea which Source becomes one with, that you must get up to speed with. Now, we don't want to belabor the point, but really, we do want to belabor the point. We want to drum it into your consciousness. We want you to leave here never ever forgetting that your life experience is going to cause a constant expansion within you that you must stay up to speed with, or you will never be satisfied. You can't leave a gap between you who you think you are in this physical body and you who you have really become as Source energy. You must stay up to speed with who you are. Recently, Jerry and Esther had exposure to a contrasting experience which caused a strong awareness of a rocket of desire to be born. And Esther said to Jerry, uh-oh. He said, what? And Esther said, there's no turning back. We cannot pull back from that which life has caused us to become. You must relax and go with the flow. And what we're wanting you to hear is that there is a way to know which way that flow is. Because what happens is, as Source becomes this new, expanded you, Source is this powerful signal that is offering this strong, strong beam that is calling you forward to it. The call of Source is ever present, always present, if you're listening for it. But you know what goes wrong? There are two things that go wrong for you, and we'll just bluntly tell you what they are so that you can get them out of the way now. Two things that keep most of you from easily becoming up to speed with who you really are. The first is that 99% of every creation is complete before you see physical evidence. And most of you let your emotions follow what you're observing. We're going to talk about how to take emotional journeys apart from what's actually happening. That's a key point. You can't keep looking at what is and have what is evolve to something else, because whatever you give your attention to is a vibration that you've activated. And when you activate a vibration, law of attraction responds to that activated vibration. Law of attraction says that which is likened to itself is drawn. Law of attraction says when you set your radio dial on 6:30 a.m., that's the signal that you're going to hear the broadcast off. In other words, you can't put your radio tuner on 6:30 and hear what's being broadcast on 98.7. The frequencies have to match up. And you can't have become this expanded being and have your tuner set on not enoughness and ever be up to speed with who you are, or more important, ever feel good as long as you are holding yourself in that separated place. So the first thing that gets in your way is you have forgotten somehow that 99.99999, almost all of your creation is completed vibrationally before the evidence starts taking shape. The other thing is that often you're hearing the guidance of Source. You're really going to like this. But it doesn't sound like you thought Source would sound. Well, Source should sound like angel singing, yes? Source should sound like joy and ecstasy and love and appreciation. And we want you to know that really is how Source sounds and feels. Maybe something's happened to you and you're over here in despair and fear. And Source, who never stops being aware of you, is calling you toward who you really are. But do you know what the call of Source sounds like to you when you are in fear or despair? It sounds like revenge. And you know how we know that? Because we understand the vibrational emotional scale. And we know that when you are in despair, you are disallowing the wholeness of who you are. In other words, on this emotional scale where appreciation and love and joy are on one end and despair and fear are on the other, grief. On the end that feels really, really good is your perception of your empowerment. That's your being tuned in, tapped in, turned on to who you really are. That's what you feel like when you're focused in a way that is so in alignment with who you really are, with the source that is you, that there is no separation between you, and you feel alive and empowered and vital. You feel wonderful. And on the other end, where you feel so awful, the reason you feel so awful is because you are perceiving that you have no power. If you've ever been in despair or grief or even fear, and you have found, and it's a sort of knee-jerk reaction, you often find it without even knowing you're finding it. And the reason you're finding it is because source is summoning you this way up the emotional scale. You find yourself in revenge or in rage or in anger. Don't you know, if you've ever come from fear or despair into that, don't you feel better? Don't you personally know that you feel better? We know you do. And the reason you feel better is because there is less resistance in rage or revenge or anger than there is in fear or grief. And anytime you are moving closer to who you really are, the sensation within your body is one of relief, because it always feels like relief when you release resistance. So the art of allowing is the art of allowing yourself to be in vibrational alignment with who you really are. Many humans are practicing the art of resistance, which is beating the drum of what I don't want and using it as my excuse to activate a vibration within me that complicates my signal and keeps me from being that one strong signal. So are you getting it that your emotions, when you feel wonderful, you're in alignment and you're sending one strong signal? And do you know, when you do that, you are powerfully influential? In other words, one who's connected to this pure positive energy is more powerful than millions who are not. And when you are focused upon things that are causing a separation in your vibration, now you've muddied your own water. Now you're sending out a sloppy signal. Now you're not getting what you want, and you're usually blaming the circumstances that are around you. And we want you to understand that it does not matter what the circumstances are around you. It only matters how you're responding emotionally to those circumstances. And when you discover that you can take an emotional journey that is different or separate from the action journey that you may be living right now, when you discover the power of guiding your thoughts for the purpose of guiding your emotions, then you've shown yourself the true art of allowing. Now, next time you're enraged over something, instead of being mad at yourself, you'll realize that you must be doing something right, because you are feeling better than you felt before when you were feeling powerless. We watch Esther. Even Esther gets angry about things from time to time, and every time she finds herself angry, she has been beating up on herself because of all of the people that she thinks should be up here in pure positive energy. It should be her. And then we explain, Esther, you were feeling powerless about something. Something was happening that made you feel powerless. And the rage is a step in the right direction. Hopefully she'll move through revenge before she acts on it. Hopefully she'll move through anger and rage before she acts on it. But we want you to stop being mad at yourself when you are in some negative state of being. Instead, we want you to bless the guidance that is within you, that is letting you know how to quantify your journey, you see. So when you get it, that when you follow that, Joseph Campbell said, follow your bliss. And we think those are the best words ever spoken by a human tongue. Follow your bliss. But sometimes you can't even get a whiff of bliss. If you're over here in rage or despair, you can't get a whiff of bliss. So the rule of thumb that we would use is, I'm going to reach for the best feeling thought I can find from where I am. And we want you to understand that you can't factor in what somebody else thinks. What they think has no bearing. There are only two points in this vibrational relativity. If you try to figure out what they want, or what they want, or what they want, or what they want, or what they want, you'll just complicate the signal. It's only your guidance system is only operating on the vibrational points of relativity between you and you, you see. So, can you imagine if Jerry and Esther were out there in the desert with their navigational system, and instead of only two points of relativity, where they are in relationship to where they want to be? Magellan's really interesting. When they follow the route that Magellan has calculated, she just purrs along. It's a woman's voice. The man's voice was far too bossy. She just purrs along. She's just happy. She gives them turn-by-turn directions. But if Jerry and Esther depart from that path, Magellan kicks up quite a squawk. She says, please return to the highlighted route. Please return to the highlighted route. Please return to the highlighted route. And if they continue to disobey, in time she will say, recalculating route. Or she will say, when possible, make a legal U-turn. Your guidance system operates the same way. You can tell in any moment in time whether the thought you're thinking, whether it's past, present, or future, is in vibrational alignment with who you have become and the signal that Source is calling you toward. Can you imagine if Jerry and Esther were out in the desert and Magellan somehow started calculating 10 other people and where they were and where they wanted to be, and then tried to give Jerry and Esther feedback about all of that, and they're looking at the map and saying, this isn't even the hemisphere we're in. How can these roads aren't anywhere near us. How can we possibly get from where we are to where we want to be with a map that is unrelated to our journey? And that's the thing that we want you to leave here today really getting, is that you've got guidance that is absolutely related to your journey. It's Source energy within you, guiding you toward that which your life has caused you to become. So now you know everything that is important. There is nothing more that we or anyone could give you that would be more important to you creating your reality, to your fulfilling your dreams, for you fulfilling your purpose for being here in the first place. Did we tell you that 99% of it is complete before you get any evidence of it? And did we tell you that in every moment you're offering a vibration, so you're marching towards something? And that you're well along your way to the manifestation of something before it manifests? Sometimes people will say to us, Abraham, it just came out of the blue. And we say, no, it didn't. It didn't just come out of the blue. You were marching toward it for a very long time. And when it manifested, that was just the last little bit of it. And so you're on the brink of all kinds of things. And you can tell by the way you feel how you're going to like it when it manifests. So we like to say that every subject is really two subjects. Like a big stick you pick up, the subject of physical wellness. On one end of it is wonderful physical conditions, and on the other end is sickness. So it's two subjects, even though it's the subject of physical body. There's the subject of abundance of dollars, and on one end there are a lovely steady flow, and on the other end not nearly enough. And so imagine that this stick is out there in your future somewhere, and on one end of it is something you're really going to like when you get there, and on the other end of it is something you're really not going to like when you get there. And the thing that we want to impress upon you is that you're marching towards something. So if you wake up and you're joyful and you're appreciative and you're full of fun and you're having a wonderful time, you're marching toward things that as they manifest, they're going to surprise and delight you. You're going to say, isn't this wonderful? You're going to say, things always work out for me. You're going to say, my life is so good. I'm so blessed. And those who watch you are going to say, what is your magic? Were you born with a silver spoon in your mouth? What kind of karma were you born under? And we say, has nothing to do with anything other than what you're doing right here and now. And as you're marching towards something that, in other words, let's say you're frustrated. Frustrated. What kind of manifestations match that? Tumors and cancer? No. Locking your car keys in? Yeah. Leaving your purse somewhere? Yeah. Showing up at a place and never being a parking place? Yes. Always getting that waiter that can't remember anything? Yes. Fearful. You know what manifests? You show up at the hotel where the suicide bomber is. In other words, law of attraction matches you up. You cannot offer a vibration and march toward it without the very things that you are worried about manifesting. Because you are the creator of your reality. And creation means rendezvousing. Creation means co-creating. Co-creation and creation means activating a vibration, and all things in this vibrational sphere that are a vibrational match to that which you are offering make their way into your